sapped of energy.
Originally as well, there was a reluctancy within the element of feeling convinced that, you know, you can't really make prison films certainly feel original too easily these days. Like people try a lot and fail, and sometimes become cliche, sometimes they're deliberately cliche. I was very keen to work out that everyone's intentions were right, and obviously figuring out that Jonathan, the writer, was effectively I was full of information anyway, because obviously he lived it. So to work out that everyone had the right intentions, and I meant that I was able to feel convinced that it wasn't just going to be another prison film where potentially we miss hit it. We were able to establish a world, live in a world, and, you know, shoot actually in a prison.
And so how long have you actually been acting?
First film was when I was 15. I think my first TV role was 13. And then prior to that, I was just pissing about, just the amateur groups and all of that. But never really set out or made a decision that I was going to become an actor. I think if I did that, then I'd have probably failed. So thankfully, it's all unfolded quite nicely. No drama school or nothing, just apprenticeship.
So when did it begin to feel like a career?
A few years ago, I think. I'll try and suss out a pivotal moment for you, but I think by the time I was on set for like weeks on end as a day job, like a full-time role, that's when it began to feel like a profession also. But at the same time, you're having a lot of fun. There's a lot of discovery involved and a lot of experimenting. And so, you know, at the same time, there's a lot of work involved as well.
Well, it's always interesting when a young guy is basically vetting the show, the director, and, you know, like, I need it to be a certain thing for me to want to go do that, as opposed to just, okay, it's a job or it's a, you know, another opportunity. So it's a, your mindset is fascinating to me at this point.
Okay, cool.
As you're developing, you know, because you're have you figured out that you have to protect yourself in that way, or?
Yeah, you have to be selective, I feel, definitely. But you're not always in a position where you can prioritize that as much as you'd like to. I've had to make sacrifices and play roles that would probably put me in a danger of being typecast and put in a position where I probably struggle to recover from it, because the idea is to, you know, play a range of people, man, not just favour my strengths.